Hello to everyone. We will now go to our topic. But before that, I would like you to give some information, background in steno. Why do we have this steno 3? Ba't napakahaba ng steno natin? Kasi in steno 1 and 2, you learn the alphabet of shorthand, as well as brief forms, word beginnings, word endings, and phrases. It was devoted to the basics of shorthand and transcription. And those basics are extremely important for further shorthand and transcription development. So in steno 3, you will continue to stress the basics, but it will also include some guidelines for document preparation. Kaya nga merong mga similar words and discussion of punctuations. So through this, it will help you develop your transcription skills and transcription speed. And then, as you progress, you will discover that shorthand is really made easy. So madali lang pala siya.
In lesson 1, we will start with theory review of the following. Word endings ing, ings, li, ingli, and ili. Sounds of ted, dead, and dit. Brief forms and phrases.
Let us now review the lessons you learned in steno 1 and 2. So let's start with the word endings. In lesson 1, it presented here all the word endings. Like the word ending ing. Ing is represented as a dot. So yan yun, di ba? Yan yung natutunan nyo sa steno 1. For example, the word is doing. D-O-ing. Doing. Next is hearing. H-E-R-ing. Hearing. Hiring. H-I-R-ing. Hiring. Interesting. Okay, do you still remember that the word beginning interest, enter, are represented as disjoint end. Kaya yung interest, short line, then S-T, ing, interesting, knowing, N-O-ing, knowing, okay? Then, thinking, so we have a brief form thing and think that represents over T-H and a dot. So, since the word is thinking, you add additional dot for the ing. Now, next is the word ending ings. The word ending ings is represented as disjoint. Pag sinabing disjoint, hiwalay siya doon sa salita. So, disjoint left S. So, disjoint left S. That is the stroke. Example, dealings. D-E-L ings, dealings. Earnings. E-R-N ings, earnings. Feelings. F-E-L-ings. Feelings. Then meetings. M-E-T-ings. Meetings. Next is the word ending li, that represents as a small circle. Briefly. B-R-E-F-ly. Briefly. Daily. D-A-Day, yung li nasa likod. Daily, early. E-R-ly, early. Extremely. E-S-T-R-E-M-ly, extremely. Fairly. F-A-R-ly, fairly. Next, how about the word ending ingly? The word ending ingly is represented as small circle then, but this time it is disjoint. Nakahiwalay siya. Halimbawa, accordingly. How do you write accordingly? A-K-O-R-D. Ingly, accordingly. Knowingly. N-O. Ingly, knowingly. Willingly, we have a brief form will and well that represents L. Then, ingly, willingly. Exceedingly, EXED, ingly, exceedingly. Next is the word ending ily. The word ending ily is represented as a circle, but this time the stroke, the symbol is flattened. It is like an egg. So, a small circle, pwedeng nakatayo, pwedeng nakahiga. But it is joined, ha? Hindi siya nakahiwalay doon sa word. Easily. E-S-E-L-Y. Easily. Family. F-A-M-E-L-Y. Family. Then, necessarily. N-A-S-S-R-E-L-Y. Necessarily. Steadily. 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 Next is the TED, the dead, and DIT. It is a combination of letter T and D. If we combine this, this will become the stroke. T, tapos naka-jug, tapos D. Pero ang ginawa dyan ni Greg, tinanggal yung jug na yan. Kaya isang mahabang combination ng T at ng D. Example of TED. Accepted. A-S-E-P-TED. Accepted. Next, acted. A-K-TED. Acted. Instead. In-S-TED. Instead. Today. TED-A-TODAY. How about the dead? Dead as in added. Added. Gray. G-R-A. Dead. Gray dead. Next is guided. G-I-D-E-D. Guided. Needed. N-E-D-E-D. Needed. How about the dit? The sound of dit. As in audit. Audit. Kasi yung audit natin, it has a sound of O. Audit, then credit. K-R-E-D-I-T, credit. Detailed. D-A-A-L, detail. Edit. Edit. Okay? Now, how about the brief forms? Review tayo ng mga brief forms natin. Such as A-N, that represents a dot. Acknowledge, A-K, that is the abbreviation. And then about, A-B. Then acknowledgement. Oh. Yung acknowledge ay gawin natin, dagdagan natin ng ment. The ment is represented as M. Acknowledgement. Advantage. Advantage is represented as a V. Disadvantage. Gawin natin disadvantage. How do you write? You add D, S, then dugtong mo yung advantage. How about advertise? Advertise. That is the abbreviation. Advertisement. Yan. Next is after. That represents A-F-T for after. Example, another. Let's make it derivatives. After noon. Next is the word M. M, that represents M. And, combination of N, D. Then, anniversary. Anniv. Yan na lang ang abbreviation niya. Any. N-E. Any. Appropriate. Appropriate. Then, appropriately. Appropriately. So, yung li, ginamit natin. Then, the R, our R. Diba? R na lang siya. And then, it at, that represents P. Now, meron tayong mga been, able.
These are the outlines for the phrases. For example, has been. Has been able. I have not been able. I will be able. I am glad. In our, it will be. We have been able.